Watching George Floyd in front of our eyes was gut-wrenching, and it was disturbing. These were several of the most horrifying minutes on video that I have ever witnessed. Mr. Floyd struggles to breathe, and he cries for help, while the officer appears indifferent, kneeling on his neck, cutting off his ability to breathe, and the other three officers fail to intervene. I was outraged and sickened by what I saw. Our hearts go out to the Floyd family. I'm saddened for the people of color in Minneapolis, St. Paul, here in Maplewood, and across our nation. We stand with all those calling for institutional reforms. As an attorney and public official, I hold the values of our Constitution dear. Through the course of our nation's history, the right to protest has forced people to pay attention to injustice, and it has moved them to action. Let's keep up that momentum, because what's happening in our communities reminds us how much further we have to go when it comes to social justice and creating equitable opportunities in education, employment, housing, and how our communities are policed. After processing the initial horror, my mind focused to Maplewood, our community, our public safety department, and specifically our police officers. I asked myself, had I, as a council member and now mayor, done all that was in my power to make Maplewood a more equitable community that ensures harmony, justice, and equitable opportunities for all in our community? Indeed, I've received numerous calls and emails asking, what is Maplewood doing? Some calling for defunding our police department, others demanding change, and others simply asking, what are we doing? Of course, we all need to do much, much more. I and the members of this council don't have all the answers. We need the community's help going forward. We can and must continue doing this together. Acknowledging that we've taken only incremental steps on a long, complicated journey, there are points of pride in what Maplewood and our community members have accomplished so far. I'd like to start by recognizing Public Safety Director Scott Nadeau, whom I'll call on in just a few moments. In the last 3 years, our police department has made significant progress improving our policing practices, engaging the community, and hiring officers that better reflect Maplewood's demographics. Even before Chief Nadeau arrived, we had witnessed systemic issues that needed to be addressed. In 2014, we saw the unrest in Ferguson and New York, and by 2016, with the killing of Philando Castile here in Minnesota, enough was enough. Then Chief Paul Schnell, at the direction of myself and Council Members Juneman and Smith, who are on council with me, developed Maplewood's response. We started the Use of Force Task Force. It helped us set the groundwork for reshaping our approach to policing. Councilmember Neblett served on that task force and now sits on the council. In the last few years, our efforts have gone far beyond focusing on just policing. Maplewood prides itself on a high quality of life, a great place to live, work, and raise a family. Policing alone will not help us ensure that. We need to build all of the community support systems that lead to success. The council adopted community inclusiveness as one of our strategic objectives by which we measure and make all of our decisions. The strategic objective states that we will strive to create a community that is engaged, tolerant, and compassionate about everyone. To further build a community that embraces and respects diversity, and that uses different perspectives and experiences to build an inclusive and equitable city for all. As elected leaders, we have all worked closely with our two school districts to help them pass construction referendums to build world-class educational facilities that meet students' evolving needs. Both superintendents came in during that effort and showed us photos of how far into disrepair our schools had become. We as a council and as a community supported these important educational initiatives because our students are our future. Students need good jobs and a pathway to middle-class careers. That's why we partnered with a St. Paul nonprofit to host a high school career fair, which attracted more than 300 students with diverse backgrounds from a variety of East Metro schools. Everyone deserves a clean, suitable, and safe place to live. After working with our housing providers, Maplewood has launched a rental housing licensing program to force bad landlords to shape up, ensuring clean, secure, well-maintained properties and units for all residents of Maplewood. During the recent demonstrations for social justice, I was heartened to see so many different faces in the crowds. That's important because while Minneapolis, St. Paul, Maplewood, and some other first-ring suburbs have diverse populations, their neighborhoods, including some of ours, are less integrated. One of the things I'm most proud of is that when we hold large-scale community gatherings, we've been able to bring all of our different backgrounds together in one celebration, giving community members a chance to meet and talk about shared experiences. It's also created a space for them to see our police officers and our officers to see them in a relaxed, informal, non-enforcement setting. It's helped melt some of the tensions because it allows people an opportunity to really connect with each other. Unfortunately, because of COVID, we're not able to hold these gatherings for the foreseeable future. That's why it's so important now that we continue working creatively together on these issues. I'm looking to folks on this DS with me, members of our newly formed Multicultural Advisory Committee, and our community as a whole to move Maplewood forward. Inclusiveness is one of our strategic objectives, and if we keep that in the front of our minds as we all consider what we can do individually and collectively as a council, a resident, or a business in Maplewood, we will make true change happen in our city. At this time, I've asked Chief Nadeau to address us and share his perspective on what Maplewood Police have done and plan to do as we move forward in the aftermath of the killing of George Floyd. Chief Nadeau?
Thank you, Mayor. The murder of George Floyd on May 25th at the hands of Minneapolis police officers has led to more than just protests, rioting, and arson. It has brought forward some fundamental questions that we all need to answer about race, equal justice, bias, and policing in America. I agree with the mayor. The brutal murder of Mr. Floyd at the hands of police officers was one of the most disgusting things I've ever witnessed. And quite frankly, it made me embarrassed in many ways of the profession that I've served in for 33 years. But this is not the first time that these issues have been brought to the forefront, as we've seen far too many examples of police use of force ending in the death of an unarmed citizen who too often are people of color. In the wake of this tragic death, and in a conversation that is occurring both nationally and locally, we have been receiving a lot of questions from our citizens in regards to what is the city of Maplewood and its police department doing in regards to bias policing, equal justice, building relationships, workforce diversity, and use of force issues. I believe that our citizens are right to be asking these questions, and I'd like to give you a brief overview of how Maplewood has been addressing these issues over the course of the last 4 years. In the wake of yet another tragedy, the police shooting of Philando Castile in July of 2016, the city of Maplewood formed a citizen task force to work with the police to discuss policing and use of force issues. The task force included citizens from diverse communities and a city council representative who spent months and a number of meetings educating themselves on issues concerning policing and police use of force issues. This group, which called itself the Use of Force Task Force, engaged the police department in facilitated dialogue and went through the entire use of force policy and training programs. They wrote an important prologue to the police department's policy manual that serves as the basis for when force is reasonable and in alignment with community standards and priorities. The group's work was an important opening on the difficult issues surrounding police use of force. When their work was done, Maplewood police officers had a better understanding of the support and the expectations of their community in regards to issues regarding force. Wanting to follow up on this work, the city council created a police advisory council, which met several times in an effort to assist the police department in offering guidance on policing issues from a community perspective. The group also performed functions such as sitting on police interview panels so that the community would have input on officers that we would want to be policing Maplewood. After several months of meetings, it was agreed that the group's work was limited by its charter, and other options were explored for a group of citizens comprising our diverse community who could assist the police through input, planning, and assistance. A report suggested that the multicultural advisory committee model, prevalent in several Hennepin County communities, would be a better and more flexible resource to the police department because of its formation. Recruitment was done, and a start date with 12 of our members was established. That has now been delayed due to COVID-19 concerns, and we are presently looking at forming that group with a starting on a Zoom meeting. We believe that having a dedicated group of community members assisting and advising the police department has shown value and will continue to be an integral part of planning, hiring, advising, and reflection into the future. In addition to working with citizens advisory and task force groups, the police department has taken a number of steps in regards to hiring, training, and connecting with our community in the past 3 years. In hiring, the Maplewood Police Department, working with our Human Resources Department, has invested a great deal of time and effort into finding the best applicants for our city and ensuring that they better reflect our diverse community. In the past 3 years, we have seen a 125% increase of non-traditional police officers, going from 8 to 18 women and people of color on our police department. We've had to get out of the box about bringing people in with different experiences and different cultural backgrounds in entry-level positions, and then assisting them and mentoring them to become great Maplewood police officers. We have prioritized training and have also mandated that all sworn staff complete training in important and impactful topic areas such as crisis intervention training, implicit bias, and de-escalation. More than just firearms and defensive tactics, Maplewood officers increasingly have the tools that they need to be successful in 21st century policing philosophies. Just as important as training is putting our police staff in situations where they can build relationships, work with, and get to know the amazing residents that make up the Maplewood community. Starting in 2018, we required every police employee, sworn and non-sworn, to do the important work of getting to know and serve our community. Each staff member is required to be involved in activities that build the important bonds of trust and respect that are vital for us to have that sort of relationship with our community. Our officers now hold dozens of events in our apartment and manufactured home communities. They work with our schools and senior citizen groups to ensure that those relationships are strong. They attend a variety of community events. They volunteer for charitable causes, and over 20 of them are currently mentors to children, many of whom are children of color, through our school-based Big Brother, Big Sister program at Weaver Elementary School. We have gone from a couple of dozen hours per year to thousands of hours per year in outreach and service to our community. While this work and these programs are important and impactful, our community also expects transparency in what we're doing and how we use enforcement in our city. In addition to citywide initiatives showing progress on council priorities, the police department also utilizes social media and a number of publications to inform our community. Our police department's strategic plan shows our community what we plan to do and how. Our annual report reflects the accomplishments, challenges, and major events that we faced that year. Our community information report is one of the most comprehensive summaries of police enforcement activity to include factors such as age, race, other demographics, and issues like victimology that is published by any metro area police agency. The public's concerns around police use of force are valid, particularly in light of events happening in Minnesota and around the country, and every police department needs to be accountable. Whether it's policy, training, or supervision, all three of these play an important role in police use of force encounters. In Maplewood, we're fortunate to have body-worn cameras and policies that mandate their use. Because of body-worn cameras, every use of force incident is examined in detail to ensure that any use of force that was necessary reflects the training and best practices that our community expects. This is a safeguard to both our officers and our community, and the best investigative tool when it comes to use of force incidents. Mayor and members of the City Council, while I've listed some of what the city and the police department has done in the last 4 years, I can tell you that we're far from done. Our police department needs and our community expects that we will continue to pursue a path that is just for all of our residents and where every person in Maplewood is respected. We need to continue this important dialogue with our residents, including those from diverse backgrounds, and build trusting and respectful relationships with our diverse faith groups and communities. Our multicultural advisory committee, community dialogues, and continued efforts on training, building relationships, and diversifying our workforce are important next steps. If there are any residents who have questions in regards to any of these issues, we make sure that all of our policies, reports, and publications are available online. For those who have additional questions, of course, we're happy to talk to any resident and share information or hear their concerns. I hope that this short summary of the path that we are on for the past 4 years is helpful for our residents' knowledge. And please know that our entire agency is committed to continuous improvement in this regard, not only this year, but in years to come. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you, Chief Nadeau. I really appreciate that update.